završavam konferenciju, gde god, podsjećam se na reči mudrog Salomona.
Better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof.
Lepše je ili bolje je završetak stvari nego početak.
So I hope and pray that the Lord will give us a very blessed conclusion for this year's conference.
Da nam Bog da dobar, blagosloven zaključak ove konferencije.
We want to thank you for your invitation and your love, fellowship and hospitality.
Želimo vam zahvaliti za vaš poziv i za vaše gostoprimstvo ovde.
It has been a great joy for us to partner with you in the work of the Lord.
Veliko je zadovoljstvo, radost što možemo biti partneri sa vama u evanđelju.
We are workers together with the Lord and workers together with one another.
Mi smo zajedno radimo sa Gospodom i jedan sa drugim, dakle smo Boži saradnici.
When Paul wrote to Philippians,
kada je Pavle pisao Filipanima,
he thanked them for their partnership with him in the work of the gospel.
On im je zahvaljivao za partnerstvo u delu Božjem.
So we want to thank you for your partnership with us in the work of the Lord.
I takođe vama želimo zahvaliti za vaše partnerstvo u delu Gospodnjem.
And you will be in our thoughts and prayers.
I vi ćete biti u našim mislima i na našim molitvama.
And we will pray that the Lord may prosper the work of the Lord in this place.
I molimo se da Gospod njegovu reč dalje blagoslovi u vašem mestu i državi.
And as and when the Lord opens the way again, we will come back and see you.
I ako Gospod otvori vrata budućnosti, rado ćemo se vratiti da vas vidimo.
Pray for our ministry in Dallas.
Molite se za našu službu u Dallasu.
And also around the world.
I takođe posvuda po svetu.
As and when the door opens.
I kada se negde vrata otvore.
And the Lord opens the opportunities.
I kada Bog otvori prilike.
And the requests and the encouragement from God's people comes to come and help.
I da kada dođe Boži poziv da jednostavno idemo.
So we will be traveling to India after 10 days.
Za 10 dana ćemo putovati u Indiju.
For a month of ministry in different parts of India.
U različitim delovima Indije ćemo biti mjesec dana.
Some of you remember my brother John Kurian.
Neki od vas poznaju moga brata Johna Kurijana.
Who have visited you some years ago.
Koji vas je pre dosta godina posetio.
And he will also be joining with me.
I on će se takođe meni pridružiti.
So pray for that trip.
Takođe molite se za ovo putovanje.
And also I'm meeting regularly with a group of young men in our assembly in Dallas.
Redovno se sastajem sa grupom mladih u Dallasu.
And to equip them to be good future leaders and elders in the assembly.
I da ih opremim da budu dobri buduće vođe u crkvi.
So pray that all these humble ministries may bring great results for God's glory.
I molite se da ove jednostavne pokorne službe donesu slavu Božem imenu.
So we will look at the Sermon on the Mount again, the Beatitudes.
I pogledat ćemo opet ova blaženstva iz Mateju.
Now we are in Beatitude number 8.
Sada smo kod osmog blaženstva.
That is in verse 10.
U desetom stihu.
The 8th and the 9th beatitude are very similar.
Osmo i deveto blaženstvo je vrlo slično.
So the 9th one is more an explanation of the 8th one.
A deveto je kao jedno objašnjenje osmoga.
In verse 10 we read.
U desetom stihu čitamo.
That is an beatitude number 8.
Dakle, to je blaženstvo broj 8.
Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake.
Blago progonjenima zbog pravednosti.
For theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Jer njihovo je carstvo nebesko.
So in verse 3, we started with the kingdom of heaven.
U trećem stihu smo počeli sa nebeskim carstvom.
So again, it is concluded in the kingdom of heaven.
I takođe u zaključku nalazimo carstvo nebesko.
And verse 11 is an explanation of verse 10.
I 11. stih je objašnjenje desetog.
Here the Lord is teaching us what will be the response of the world to the kingdom standards.
Ovde čitamo kakav će biti odgovor sveta u pogledu na standarde njegovog kraljestva.
So far we have been talking about kingdom standards.
Do sada smo govorili o standardima kraljevstva.
That when we are committed to the kingdom standards,
kada smo predani Božim standardima,
and when we start living the kingdom life here upon this earth,
počinjemo živjeti ovim kraljevstvom nebeskim ovdje na zemlji,
how will the world respond to us?
Kako će svet da odgovori?
The world will not give us Nobel Prize.
Ovaj svet nam neće dati Nobelovu nagradu.
Because our standards are very different.
Zato što su naši standardi vrlo drugačiji.
Our values are different.
Naše vrednosti su drugačije.
So the Lord said, the response will be persecution.
I Gospod ovdje kaže da će odgovor biti progonstvo.
Because the world is under the domain of the darkness, the evil one.
To je ovaj svet u vlasti tame. Zloga.
The whole world is under the evil one, we read in 1 John.
Ceo svet je u vlasti zloga, kako čitamo u 1. Jovanovoj.
And the world cannot stand the kingdom citizens.
I svet tu se jednostavno gade stanovnici nebeskog
kraljestva. And when you talk about kingdom standards, about marriage and family, the world cannot tolerate it.
I kada govorimo o standardima Božjeg carstva što se tiču braka i porodice, to svet ne može da podnese.
Let me tell you, the pagan heathen nations tolerate it better than America. America is intolerable the moment you talk about marriage and family, Christian marriage and family.
U poganskom svetu to izgleda bolje nego kod nas u Americi, da u Americi ne mogu da podnesu ovo izučavanje što se tiče carstva nebeskog, što se tiče braka i porodice.
The Hindu nation India has more respect for marriage and family than the so-called evangelical Christian country of the United States.
U hinduističkoj kulturi u Indiji ima više poštovanja prema braku i porodici nego što ima u Americi među evangelikalnim hrišćanima.
Because superficial evangelicalism.
Zbog tog površnog sveta hrišćanskog.
Compromising on the word of God.
Koji čini kompromis sa Božjom reči.
Want to change the truth of God's word in the name of culture.
Koji žele da promene, izmene Božju reč u svetlu neke kulture.
And those who stand strong for the truth,
a oni koji stoje čvrsto za istinu,
they are ridiculed and they are persecuted.
Njih se ismeva i progoni.
They are not put in prison like in other countries.
Možda nisu stavljeni u zatvor kao nekim drugim zemljama.
But the whole culture and liberal media, they are totally against evangelical Christianity.
Ali čitava kultura i javno mnjenje je protiv hrišćanstva.
A kind of subtle persecution.
Kao neko podmuklo progonstvo.
So the Lord predicted, the Lord said that you will be persecuted when you stand for the kingdom agenda.
I Gospod je već prorekao da će se to desiti kada budete čvrsto stali za hrišćanskom sikšerskim standardima.
And I know that this is true world over.
I znam da je to posuda po svetu.
Persecuted for righteousness sake.
Progonjeni zbog pravednosti.
So kingdom righteousness, when we exercise, when we practice it, you will be persecuted.
Kada primenjujemo u praksi standarde kraljevstva nebeskog, bit ćemo progonjeni.
Because the Lord said, but you are blessed.
Ali Gospod kaže, blago vama.
And then, yours is the kingdom of heaven.
Vaše je kraljevstvo nebesko.
And verse 11
is kaže,
and a personal application of verse 10.
To je kao lična primjena tog 10. stiha.
Blessed are you when they revile and persecute you and say all kinds of evil against you falsely for my name's sake.
Blago vama kad vas zbog mene vređaju i progone i nabeđuju za svako zlo.
So it is for me you are suffering. For my name's sake.
Zbog mene i radi mene trpite.
It is not for your kingdom, for your agenda.
To nije zbog vašeg kraljevstva, zbog vaše agende.
You are persecuting because you are representing Jesus of Nazareth.
Vi ste progonjeni zato što predstavljate Isusa iz Nazareta.
And his kingdom.
I njegovo kraljevstvo.
Blessed are you.
Blago vam.
because you are suffering it for my name's sake.
Jer trpite zbog mog imena.
And you are, you know, they bring evil charges against you falsely.
I na vas nabeđuju zle stvari, svako zlo, dakle lažno.
Verse 12, rejoice and be exceedingly glad.
Radujte se i kličite.
You be, you know, it's a superlative usage. Get really excited.
To je rečeno u superlativu, dakle budete jako uzbuđeni.
Exceedingly glad.
Previše biti radostan.
Because your reward, even heaven will be great.
Jer je velika vaša nagrada na nebesu.
Because you lived as kingdom citizens here and now.
Jeste živeli kao građani neba, nebeskog kraljestva ovde i sada.
You may not be a preacher or a teacher.
Možda niste učitelj, propovednik.
You may not be a theologian or a scholar or an elder or a leader.
Niste neki učenjak, neki starešina zajednice, znamenit čovjek.
But as a faithful child of God.
Dakle, samo verno dete Božje.
You are a kingdom citizen.
Ti si građanin nebeskog kraljestva.
For living out the kingdom values.
I što živiš ove vrednosti njegovog kraljestva.
In your life.
U tvom životu.
In your home.
U tvom domu.
Wherever the Lord has placed you.
Gde god te Bog postavi.
You will be rewarded.
Bićeš nagrađen.
Thinking about it, you be glad. You be happy.
I dok razmišljaš o tome, ti si radostan.
You are blessed by the Lord.
Blagosloven si od Gospoda.
And you will have exceeding reward.
Imaćeš veliku nagradu.
Not only that.
Ne samo to.
You will be in line with the prophets of old.
Bićeš kao u liniji tih proroka pre što su bili.
For they persecuted the prophets before you.
Jer su tako progonili i proroke pre vas.
What was the message of the prophets?
Kakva je bila poruka proroka?
Kingdom agenda.
A to je bila agenda, dakle, misli,
standards, kingdom
standardi, Božje kraljestvo.
Calling people to God's kingdom standards.
Koji su pozivali narod da slušaju Božje standarde.
Even when they strayed and when they backslided, the prophets constantly called them back to God.
Uvek kada su zastranili, omašili, prorok Božji je pozivao nazad.
But the prophets also were persecuted.
Ali ti proroci su bili progonjeni.
So you are in good company.
Dakle, imamo dobro društvo.
You are in company with the prophets.
Mi smo u društvu proroka.
And you will have great rewards.
Imaćete velike nagrade.
Because it is for my name's sake.
Zato što je to zbog mog imena.
And they do this falsely to you. There is, you know, no truth in these accusations.
I oni su to radili bez da su imali istinu. Dakle, lažno su vas nabeđivali za sve zlo.
So those are the 9 pronouncements of blessing.
Dakle, tu imamo tih 9 izjava o blagoslovima.
This is not talking about good luck.
Ovo ne govori o dobroj sreći.
Not simply certain things to make you happy.
Ne o nekim stvarima da vas učine srećnim.
These are wonderful blessings he has promised to us.
Ovo su predivni blagoslovi koje nam je on obećao.
As we live as kingdom citizens.
Dok živimo kao građani nebeskog kraljestva.
Now then the rest of these chapters 5 and 6 and 7.
I onda ostatak ovih glavlja 6 i 7.
The sermon continues.
Nastavlja se propoved.
The most important sermon in the New Testament.
Najvažnija propoved u Novom Zavetu.
Oh, the greatest sermon ever preached.
Najveća propoved ikada propovedana.
It impacted so many people around the world, Christians and non-Christians.
Uticala na hrišćane i nehrišćane posvuda po svetu.
So we looked at the beginning of this sermon.
Dakle, gledali smo na početak ove propovedi.
I have been very much blessed by looking at the conclusion of this sermon.
Ali ja sam također bio blagosloven kada sam gledao naš zaključak ove propovedi.
So shall we turn in the same sermon, chapter 7.
I molim da okrenemo sada u 7. glavi, Mateju.
24 to 29 is the conclusion of the sermon.
24. stiha do 29. nalazimo zaključak ove propovedi.
Many people when they study the sermon on the mount they do not pay much attention to the conclusion.
I mnogi ljudi kada studiraju ovu propoved ne daju dovoljno pažnje na poslednja reč, na zaključak.
Now one thing very interesting I found in this sermon.
Nešto što sam našao vrlo interesantno u ovoj propovedi.
The Lord Jesus was a good communicator.
Gospod Isus je bio dobar komunikator.
There is an introduction to the in the sermon.
Ima uvod u propoved.
Then there is the body of the sermon.
I onda ima telo propovedi.
Some illustrations to prove his point.
Nekoliko ilustracija da dokažu njegovu nameru.
And then there is a conclusion in the sermon.
Ima i zaključak propovedi.
So that's a good example.
To je vrlo dobar primjer.
An introduction and a developed body and a conclusion.
Uvod, razrada i zaključak.
So here we come to the conclusion of the sermon.
Dolazimo do zaključka ove propovedi.
Verse
24.
Chapter 7.
Sedma glava.
Therefore, whoever hears these sayings of mine and does them, I will liken him to a wise man who built his rock on the rock.
Stoga svaki ko sluša moje reči, izvršava ih, sličan mudrom čovjeku koji svoju kuću sazidao na steni.
It is Sunday school story, we know.
Mi znamo, ovo je priča za nedeljnu školu.
The wise man built his house upon the rock.
Mudar čovjek gradi kuću na steni.
But there is something very important to this conclusion.
Ali ima vrlo značajno nešto za ovaj zaključak.
See, the Lord did not say,
znate, Gospod Isus nije rekao,
here in this conclusion,
u ovom zaključku,
about building your life upon him.
Da gradimo svoj život na njemu.
But what did the Lord say?
Šta Gospod kaže?
Whoever hears these teachings, these sayings of mine,
koji izvršava moje reči, ove moje izjave,
and does them,
i izvršava,
I will liken him to a wise builder.
Ja ću, on je kao sličan mudrom čovjeku.
In our salvation, we build our house upon Christ himself, the rock.
U našem spasenju, dakle, gradimo svoj život na njemu, na steni.
I think this is what people miss when you come to the conclusion.
I mislim da ovo promiče. Nedostaje ljudima kada studiraju ovo.
The Lord does not specifically say about building your life on him.
Dakle, Gospod Isus specifično tu ne govori, gradite svoj život na meni.
For a child of God, that is a settled issue. We have already built our life upon Christ.
Za Božje dete to je već rešena stvar. Mi svoj život gradimo na Gospodu Isusu Hristu.
Then we have a further responsibility.
Ali imamo i dalje odgovornosti.
Build our sanctification life on his teachings, on his word.
Živimo svoj život posvećivanja na njegovim naučavanjima.
Justification life on the rock of ages, Christ.
Dakle, život opravdanja je na steni, na Hristu.
But what did the Lord say? I'm just saying what the Lord said.
Ali šta kaže Isus? Ja samo citiram Isusa, šta on kaže?
The Lord said, whoever hears and does these teachings, these words of mine.
Onaj koji sluša moje reči, moje poduke, moje naučavanja.
So the Lord is asking me to build my daily life upon this earth, upon his teachings, upon his word.
I Gospod traži od mene da svoj život gradim, izgrađujem na tome šta on podučava.
That is why he has given us this word.
I zato nam je dao ovu reč.
In the Sermon on the Mount, amazing teachings.
Predivna poučavanja u propovedi na gori.
So these sayings of mine.
Dakle, ove moje reči, ovo moje poučavanje.
In the context, I will just review what did the Lord teach us in the Sermon on the Mount.
U kontekstu ja ću nekako da vam pregled šta Gospod naučava u propovedi.
The Lord told us in the beginning what is the true blessing.
Na početku on kaže koji su ti pravi blagoslovi.
Then he taught about the kingdom righteousness.
Govori o pravednosti carstva.
Then he talked about prayer.
Govori o molitvi.
About fasting.
O postu.
About forgiveness.
O oproštenju.
About worship.
O štovanju.
About relationship.
O odnosima.
About the problem of anger.
O problemu gnjeva.
About the problem of lust.
O problemu požude.
About marriage.
O braku.
About adultery.
O preljubi.
About divorce.
O razvodu.
Look at that, he said about all these things.
O svim ovim stvarima je rekao.
And now he is saying.
A sada kaže.
I let me tell you when I as I conclude.
Da vam kažem sada kada zaključim.
You won't find this in the commentary because commentators all say, oh, build your life upon Christ. That's not what the text is saying.
Nećete naći ovo u komentarima, da obično u komentarima piše da gradimo svoj život na Hristu. Jel?
These logos, these works of mine which you have heard, build upon it.
Ove reči, ove što sam izgovorio, na tim gradite.
We are preoccupied with the other thought that we have built our life upon Christ.
Imamo preokupaciju
our life is already built on Christ.
Na život je već postavljen na Hristu.
That is our salvation.
To je naše spasenje.
When we receive him as our savior.
Kada smo ga primili kao svog spasitelja.
We do not know much of his teaching.
Nismo mnogo znali
od njegovog učenja. We do not know much of the Bible.
Nismo mnogo znali iz Biblije.
We know, Lord, I am a sinner.
Mi smo znali, Gospod, ja
sam grešnik. You loved me and died for me.
Ti si me kupio, ti si umro za mene.
In repentance and faith I come to you.
Pokajanju u veri prilazim tebi.
Have mercy upon me a sinner.
Budi milosti meni grešnome.
I receive you as my savior.
Primam te kao svoga spasitelja.
When I came to Christ.
Kada dolazim.
At the age of 16.
Kada sam došao kao 16.
That's all I knew.
To je sve što sam znao.
But there I built my house upon the rock of the ages.
Ali onda sam izgrađivao svoj život na steni vekova.
That is an eternal transaction.
To je večno,
something complete,
završeno.
And then I know that probably this is true of all of you.
I onda verovatno to je istina za sve vas.
But then there is a tendency for believers, for Christians.
A onda ima sklonost vernika, hrišćana.
I'm going to heaven anyway.
Idem ja u nebo, bez obzira.
My salvation is secure.
Moje spasenje je sigurno.
Then, I can live any way I like.
Mogu da živim kako hoću.
That is the warning here.
Ovde je to upozorenje.
We have a responsibility to build our life upon his teachings.
Imamo odgovornost da gradimo svoj život na njegovim podučavanjima.
If that is not the meaning of it, tell me what is the meaning of it. I would like to know.
Ako to nije istina, ako to nije smisao, recite mi vi.
Those who build their life on the teachings of mine.
Oni koji grade svoj život na mojim izučavanjima, podučavanjima.
So that is our sanctification life.
To je naš život posvećivanja.
These teachings which I have given you.
Ove reči koje sam vam dao.
And I gave you some of the very important topics already dealt with in the sermon.
Već sam vam dao određene teme koje se tiču u ove propovedi na gori.
Then he taught us through his apostles.
I onda nas je izučavao kroz njegove apostole.
So the entire New Testament.
I čitao Novi Zavet je tu.
Then the upper room discourse, another part of his direct teachings.
Imamo još razgovor u gornjoj sobi, opet njegovo direktno podučavanje.
John 14 through 16.
Jovanovo evanđelje od 14. do 16. glave.
Direct teaching.
Direktno podučavanje.
Sermon on the Mount, direct teaching.
I propoved na gori, direktno podučavanje.
Then further teaching through the holy prophets and apostles.
I dalje podučavanje kroz proroke i apostole.
Dear brothers, we are called to build our life, our ministry, our mission, everything on his word.
Dakle, drage braćo i sestre, mi smo podučavani da svoj život izgrađujemo na naučavanjima koje je Gospod Isus dao.
And what did the Lord say?
I šta Gospod Isus kaže?
If you do that,
ako to radiš,
I liken you to a smart, a wise man.
Ja ću te uporediti s jednim mudrim čovjekom.
Who built his life on the rock.
Koji je sazidao svoju kuću na steni.
On the rock of my teaching.
Na steni mojih izučavanja.
And then the Lord said, the rain descended.
I onda Gospod kaže, pada kiša.
Did you note that? The Lord did not say the rain may come, not like the weatherman.
On ne kaže kao ovaj meteorolog, možda će doći kiša.
A 40% chance.
Možda 40% da će
mogućnosti. No, the Lord said the rain will come.
Gospod kaže, kiša će doći.
And the floods came.
I dođe bujica.
And the winds blew.
I vetrovi dunoše.
That is the attacks against your life.
To je napad na tvoj život.
That is the persecution about which he talked earlier.
To je to progonstvo o kojem je ranije govorio.
It may include the trials of life.
Može doći ti te nevolje na tvoj život.
The challenges in our life.
Dođu mnogi izazovi.
The temptations of life.
Iskušenja života.
The problems of life.
Problemi u životu.
The Lord did not say it may come.
Gospod nije rekao možda
će doći. No, the Lord said it came. It will come.
Kaže sigurno dolaze.
And it blew on the house.
I obrušiše se na kuću.
And the house did not fall, verse 25.
Ona se ne sruši, 25. stih.
Did you see that? The house did not fall.
Kuća nije pala.
All these things came.
Sve ove stvari su došle.
It did not fall.
A ona kuća nije pala.
It is guaranteed.
Garantovana.
It will not fall.
Neće pasti.
Dear brother,
draga brat,
if you build your life upon the words of Jesus Christ, upon the holy truth,
ako gradiš svoj život na Isusu Hristu, na njegovim istinama,
your ministry and your mission,
i tvoja služba, tvoja misija,
your business, your marriage,
i tvoje poslovanje, i tvoj brak,
your education, your decisions,
i tvoje obrazovanje, tvoje odluke,
brothers and sisters, if we build it on his word,
ako to gradite na njegove reči,
it is guaranteed, it will not fall,
garantovano neće pasti.
Who is saying that? Alex Kurian is not saying
it. Ko to kaže? Alex Kurian to ne kaže.
It is not the word of the conference here.
To nije reč konferencije.
It is the infallible, inerrant word of the Son of God.
Dakle, to nepogrešiva reč Božja.
Heaven and earth may pass away.
Nebo i zemlja će proći.
But not a dot or a tittle from this word will pass away.
Nijedna jota od ove reči neće proći.
It did not fall.
Nije pala.
Then verse 26.
Onda 26. stih.
Everyone who hears these sayings of mine and does not do them.
A koji sluša ove sve moje reči, a ne izvršava.
Yeah, it is a question of obedience.
Dakle, to je pitanje poslušnosti.
Obedience of following him.
Poslušnost da ga sledimo.
Obedience to his word.
Poslušnost njegove reči.
Obedience to his revealed will.
Poslušnost njegove objavljenoj volji.
And if those who do not do that, obey it.
Koji to ne izvršavaju, koji nisu poslušni.
The Lord said, I will like that man to a foolish man who built his house on the sand.
Gospod kaže, sličan je ludom čovjeku koji je svoju kuću sazidao na pesku.
He may be a believer.
Možda je vernik.
But he built his house on the sand.
Ali gradi svoju kuću na pesku.
On the opinions of others.
Na mišljenjima drugih.
Ha, they said, buy this plot and build it here.
A kažu, pa ovo je dobro deo, ovo je dobra, dobri, dobro mesto.
Ah, it is closer to the city.
Bliže je mestu.
There is a river nearby.
Ima tu blizu reka.
You can get cool breeze every day.
Možda ti doći vrlo hladan
dan. And when you sell it, you will make more profit.
A ako ga ako je prodaš, dobit ćeš više novca.
Oh, his family had one opinion. His family have one opinion.
I njegova porodica imala jedno mišljenje.
And his wife has another opinion.
Žena ima drugo mišljenje.
And his friends have another opinion.
Prijatelji imaju drugo mišljenje.
His in-laws have another opinion.
Drugi, mnogi imaju razna mišljenja.
And he forgot about this.
Zaboravio na ovo.
And he start building his life upon those opinions.
I počinje da gradi svoj život na mišljenjima drugih.
That is how he gets married.
Tako se i oženi.
That's how he tries to lead his Christian life.
Tako pokušava da živi svoj život hrišćanski.
What did the Lord say?
Gospod šta kaže?
The rains came.
Dolazi.
The winds blew.
Kiša i vetar duva.
And what happened to this house?
Šta se dešava sa ovom kućom?
Look at exactly what the Lord said.
Pogledajmo ta
verse 27.
27.
And the rain descended.
I pade kiša.
See, because there, it was built on the sand and no foundation.
Bila izgrađena na pesku bez temelja.
The floods came and the winds blew.
Naiđe bujica I vetrovi donoše.
And beat on that house.
I sručiše se na tu kuću.
And it fell.
I ona se sruši.
It will fall.
Pala je.
At the judgment seat of Christ.
Na pred sudnom stolicom Hristovom.
You will be saved.
Bićeš spašen.
But your works.
Ali tvoje delo.
Your life.
Tvoj život.
Burned.
Će izgoreti.
It fell, the Lord said.
Sruši se, kaže Gospod.
And great was its fall.
I usilan tresak.
See, the Lord wanted to add an effect to it.
And Gospod hteo da doda još tu jedan efekat.
So he used the word Megale. Megale! Great, great was its fall.
Koristi tu reč mega, dakle velik, velik, silan tresak.
In the parallel passage in Luke 6, Luke mentions immediately it fell.
U paralelnom odlomku u Evanđelju po Luki kaže odmah pade.
See, these two fellows, they might have built side by side.
A možda su ove dve osobe izgradili kuću jednu pored drugih.
The wise man and the foolish man.
Mudar čovjek I bezumnik.
Nearby, side by side.
Dakle, jedan pored drugog.
And the house built on the sand might have looked better, beautiful and attractive.
Možda je kuća na pesku izgledala lepša, atraktivnija, privlačnija.
Everybody appreciated it.
I svako je cenio.
And what was the difference?
A šta je bio kakva je bila razlika?
Only in the foundation.
Samo u temelju.
And when the rains come,
a kada dođe kiša,
and the floods come,
I to naiđe bujica,
then you cannot change foundation.
Onda ne možete promeniti
temelj. Ah, we have seen people like that.
Videli smo takve ljude.
When there is a difficulty, a trial or a problem,
kada dolaze poteškoće, ispitivanje, problemi,
then they immediately want to change foundation.
Odmah žele da promene temelj.
The Lord said it won't work.
A Gospod kaže, to ne funkcioniše.
I wish I could say it in any other way.
Ja bih želio da bude neko
drugačije. But the text does not allow me.
Ali to mi ne dozvoljava.
This is the conclusion to the greatest of the sermons of Jesus Christ.
Ovo je zaključak najveće Isusove propovedi.
You cannot change foundation in the midst of an earthquake.
Ne možete promeniti temelj usred zemljotresa.
It should have been done earlier.
Trebalo je to ranije da se uradi.
And then when Jesus had ended this saying.
I onda je završio svoju besedu.
That is how he concluded the sermon.
Tako je završio svoju propoved.
So today, like in homiletics, you are taught that, oh, you should end your sermon in a nice, cozy, sweet, honey type of manner.
A danas u homiletici vas podučavaju da završite svoju propoved nekako lepo, ljubazno, kako...
Forget it. Forget it.
Zaboravite na to.
What does... When the Bible does not sanction things, don't worry about such things.
Ako Biblija o tom ne govori sa odobrenjem, zaboravite.
Look at how the Lord concluded his sermon.
Pazite, kako je Gospod završio svoju
propoved. Calling people to the realities of life.
Priziva ljude na realno života.
The people were astonished at his teaching.
Narod se divio njegovom učenju.
For he taught them as one having authority.
Jer ih uče kao onaj koji ima vlast.
And not as the scribes.
A ne kao njihovi učitelji zakona.
He was teaching as an authoritative lord.
On je to podučavao kao vladar koji ima autoritet.
He is the king, he is the lord, he is savior, he has supreme authority.
On je kralj, on je spasitelj, on ima najveću vlast nad svime.
Who is the authority of your life?
Ko je autoritet u tvom životu?
That is the truth of the Sermon on the Mount.
To je istina iz propovedi na gori.
See, the word exousia, authority, which Matthew used here.
Ta reč exousia, koju Matej koristi ovde u ovom stihu.
In the coming chapters, Matthew uses it a number of times.
U nadolazećim glavama, Matej ponovo I ponovo koristi tu reč.
And at the end of the gospel.
A na kraju evanđela.
All authority is given to me.
Kaže Isus, dana mi je svaka vlast.
the king's authority.
Kraljevska vlast.
And that is where we must submit.
I pod njegovu vlast se moramo podrediti.
Lord, I submit to your authority.
Gospode, podređujem se tvojim autoritetom.
Your blessings.
Tvojim blagoslovima.
Even though the conclusion was very sober and serious.
Iako je ovaj zaključak bio jako ozbiljan.
Remember, he promised the blessings already.
Ne zaboravite, on je već obećao blagoslove.
Someone has said the sermon starts with the words of a great blessing. Words of great blessing.
Da propovjed na gori počinje sa velikim izjavama blagoslova.
And it concludes with the sound of a crash.
A završava sa zvukom silnog treska.
We want to concentrate not on the crash but on the blessings.
Ali želimo našu pažnju da usredstavimo ne na onaj tresak,
by submitting to the authority of the Lord.
Time što se podređujemo pod autoritet našeg Gospoda.
Such a wonderful savior.
Kakav predivan spasitelj.
Loved you and gave himself for you on the cross.
Koji te volao i dao samoga sebe na krstu.
And he has promised that until the day of his coming.
I on je rekao sve do dana kada dođe ponovo.
And he will carry you home until you reach home.
Da će te voditi dok ne dođeš kući.
And we are looking forward to that day.
Mi očekujemo taj dan.
When he will come back.
Kada će se vratiti.
In the glorious day of the rapture.
U predivnom, slavnom danu vaznesenja.
Believers from all over the world.
Kada će vernici posvuda po svetu.
All those who are under his authority.
Svi oni koji su pod njegovim autoritetom.
They will join together and will be raptured.
Zajedno će biti vazneti.
And to be forever with him and to worship him forever.
I bit će zajedno sa njim i klanjati mu se.
So that day is coming.
Taj dan dolazi.
That is our blessed hope.
To je naša blagoslovena nada.
As we wait for that day.
A dok očekujemo taj dan.
Let us pray that Lord help me to live under your authority.
Molimo se da nam Gospod pomogne da živim pod njegovim autoritetom.
And enjoy those wonderful blessings you have.
I da uživamo u predivnim blagoslovima koje imamo.
So may we go back to our respective homes with this blessed thoughts in our hearts.
I tako odlazimo kućama našim sa ovim blagoslovenim mislima.
Making the right decisions in our life.
Da se ispravno odlučujemo u našem životu.
And let us live for his glory in the days to come.
I da živimo za njegovu slavu dok on ne dođe.
Thank you. May his name be glorified.
Hvala i njegovo ime neka proslavljeno.
Amen. Amen.